This flickering and the resultant stroboscopic effect can be undesirable, especially in places with moving or rotating parts, as they can appear to rotate or move slowly and can cause accidents. Now we will eliminate the stroboscopic effect using a tube light which has capacitors in series. So now there is a normal tube light switched on and we can see the stroboscopic effect. Now I will switch on the other tube light which is capacitor in series. So we can see that the stroboscopic effect has been greatly reduced. If we have a single phase supply and we want to eliminate the stroboscopic effect, we can make use of capacitors. We can connect capacitors to tube lights or to alternate tube lights such that the phase we have phase shift and the voltage reaching T1 is out of phase from the voltage of T2. So when the brightness of T2 is very low, T1 has some brightness and the net brightness is not zero, thereby eliminating the stroboscopic effect. Just make sure that the value of capacitance is such that the value of impedance after adding the capacitor is more or less the same as before the adding the capacitor, so that the current does not change appreciably. If the value of the capacitor is very less, then the reactance will be very high and the tube light won't be able to switch on. And if its value is such that XL minus XC is very small, then the current will be very high, which will result in excessive heating and decrease the life of the tube light. In my case, I had a 2.59 microfarad capacitor available. And so you can see that the value of the impedance after adding the capacitance is more or less the same as before. Connecting adjacent tube lights to different phases so that the net brightness is not zero at any point of time. Even when the brightness due to T1 is zero, when the R phase voltage is zero, the brightness of T2 is not zero. So the net brightness will not be zero and the stroboscopic effect will be greatly reduced.